It's gonna be fast in the first round here, guys. King of the Hill. Look at this team. One match each. No messing about. Let's have a look over at the blue team here. The Doggos are over here. We got Salmon, Iceberg, Indy, Vintrol, Shawnee, Potter, and Orc. Then over on the red team, we got New Gamer, Nickname Twinkle, Ren Raven, Grandma, and Toxic Lima. Just gotta get used to the controls again. Right click to get me out of a hero. Okay, Brigitte Lindholm coming in for the red team here as the damage starts flowing out from the blue team against that shield. Wall comes up for the red team. That's a cheeky little wall right there. They don't manage to capitalize on it though. They're still moving forward with the flame strike kill on Vintrol right there. Grandma with the kill on Shawnee, and it looks like an easy wipe for the red team right there. Really liking that May pick, putting up the wall. The hype in the chat, the crowd's going wild on the first fight. I can hear them all cheering in the background. Now, how is the blue team gonna come back from this? The Salmon surprisingly got himself 76% ultimate, even though they got kinda rolled in that fight right there. Just building it up, he's got the blue beam on him consistently. Big wall coming in, taking down Sean right there. Looks like another push is gonna be thwarted right there as Sean goes down to the big May wall. And he's gonna be looking to build up the duplication. Again, really fast ultimate, even though the fight is not going in their favor. And he's probably gonna look to take the Reinhardt here and get himself into that fight. There we go, the duplication is in. The teleporter is in. He can take the tele here. I don't know if he's noticed. I don't think he's noticed, but he could have been in there swinging in the back line. He wanted to take the front line. Slam comes in. Ice block coming in from Grandma there. Perfectly timed. Absolutely beautiful play by Grandma. And, oh, it's a very tight fight here. We got Sigma in there. It looks like Sean. Wait, where are my health bars? Why have I got no health bars on top of the heads? Should I not have health bars? I don't know. Anyway, Sean down, Salmon down. Iceberg with the res on Sean there. He does not have ultimate. He's just getting bashed in. It's not looking good for the Doggos here as the red team holds the choke point. Teleporter coming in, looking for some frags. No, they descend the entire team through block on the slam as well as they now become the defending team on the point. Big Sigma all coming in, taking down Toxic. Vintrol with the kill on Renraven, the Moira as well. And the blue team completely wipes the red team here as they just throw in that crazy, crazy teleporter. No fucks given, straight onto the back line. Salmon is now on the Tracer, giving up on that Echo, seeing what he can do here. He's got a Brigitte to contest with, and he's gonna start working on this Reaper as well on the left side. Nickname, keeping his distance. Not that he wants to, but just because he has to. And the Symmetra kill coming in there on Renraven as well. The Symmetra spam going to be really good on this choke point right here as Salmon comes through looking for that kill. Oh, and it looks like he wants to go for the May, but the big icicle to Salmon's face. He goes down. And the red team, what is this teleporter? They're really crazy with these teleporters right here. Red team going to push through into five. Right here, we got a 6 vs 5 situation as they respawn and come in. Big freeze coming in. Remember, they're at 83% here. Big spin coming in from Nickname, taking down two of the enemy, which is going to allow them to push into this point on 83%. And if they do take this, with the Graviton Surge loaded up as well, I can't see how the blue team is possibly going to retake this. They kind of need to take down Zarya ASAP without getting grabbed, which is probably gonna, they're gonna probably have to rely on a weird telly right here. And you see actually Symmetra sneaking around the left side, going for the double turret on the back line. The wall is available. It needs to come down a little bit faster. It does come down, but nothing is really happening here. And the red team is gonna not lose the point. What's happening on the point here? It looks like we got Vintrol jumping around, delaying the point. As Salmon gets a pick with the pulse bomb. They're not doing too bad considering the situation here, actually. He's jumping around the point. We've got Shawnee Potter getting the kill on Reinhardt as he drops the beat on top of the point. Shawnee comes in. This is an amazing turnaround if they can do it. Sigma picking him up, throwing him down, clapping him up. Left side is Moira. Look at this turnaround from the blue team right here. I can't believe they've done it. Vintrol with two more frags on the back line. Lucio going crazy here. You thought we were going to spectate the DPS for the frags. Well, here you go. We're supporting, we're watching the support for the frags here. Vintrol playing out of his mind right here, delaying the point, getting the kills. All in on the support here. What can he do on this one? He's got the speed boost loaded, knocking the Reaper back right here. Looking at the ulti, and neither team really has ultimates here, but Nickname is pretty close to an ultimate actually. So we're going to jump over to Nickname and see if he can build that ult. He's 87%, 27 HP, 102 now, going behind the wall. He's been taken down by none other than Vintral, dude. That's four frags in a row for Vintral right there. Just disallowing everything from the enemy team. Oh, what can they do here? I feel like it's up to Nickname to get back to the point and hit the big spin to turn this around. It's possible. Can he do it? He does touch the point. He's got the spin. He's spinning. It's not going to happen, though. Soaked up by the Shawnee Potter Matrix right there. As we zoom out and watch this bomb, the blue team. What a massive turnaround here, dude. They were completely out of this game. Somehow they managed to survive, staggering back onto the point, dodging the Graviton surges. This is insane, dude. This is insane, dude. Score 1-0. Team Doggos clapping it up. Absolutely mental. Uwu wants to get out of the room. Food's ready for me, chat. It's all going on over here. Uwu's running around. Food's being cooked. The smell's coming through the house. But more importantly, we've got Symmetra on the blue team here. Going for the big telly in the window, I would assume. Yep, there we go. Gonna allow them to get the point here. This is one of the best Symmetra King of the Hill maps in the entire Overwatch map pool. Now the red team has to push in. Team Doggos with the big brain strats here. The weird part about this is that they're playing Winston. Vintral with another kill! He can't be stopped! He's just slaying left, right, and center. We got Farrah at the back here. That's going to be the one thing. It is Grandma as well. She is known for her Farrah. So this could definitely be huge. Going for the double kill right there. Coming up on the 100%. Three kills for the red team as they come in here. Again, it's a weird one, dude. It's a weird one. Like, I feel like if they had shields on the point there, they would have done a lot better, but they just had the Winston. Doesn't really allow you to secure the point. And we're gonna have Justice coming in soon. What can they do to stop it? Well, they've picked an Ashe. They've picked their own Pharah as well. But in terms of, like, actual stuns and stuff like that, they don't really have anything. So I feel like this Justice is gonna go big. A nice direct on Vintral right there. Taking down the main DPS of the blue team, but Semen comes in. Two big Pharah players in one game. Semen and Grandma, both Pharah mains. Looking to prove which one is better. And I mean, I would say it's pretty even so far. Semen with one direct on the Grandma. As he goes in just a little bit deeper, gets taken down by the Orisa. What is happening here? This round's a bit crazy. It looks like what's happening up there. Winston trying to get the kill on Grandma as she yeets herself out. Oh, she doesn't make it, dude. Blue team takes the point. Very close round again. Sean jumping in, doing a little bit of damage at the front right there. We got Ashe and we got Pharah on both teams. Very similar team comps here. Not exactly the same, but pretty similar. Obviously, the blue team's got the Winston, so they're going to be a little bit faster. We got Grandma. Check this out. We got Grandma sneaking around the side here. She does have Justice ready to go as well. Maybe could have gone a bit sneakier there and been on top. Who knows? Which is going to be around there anyway. Just got to save her Mercy. Sean managing to jump back onto the map as... Oh, Vintral again! Another kill! Let's get another zoom in. Every time I zoom in, he stops fragging, but he just keeps killing everyone. On the side here, going through the window. Healing up his team. Nice play. He's got the beat drop as well. If anything gets a bit sour here, he does drop the beat. Manages to save Semen over there, who did just drop his ult and didn't get anything done with it. We still have Grandma coming back in with the Justice right here. She's just going to be looking for a big one, and she needs a big one as well. Oh, she gets taken down. It's not looking too hot for the red team, but somehow they do manage to get a couple of frags here. Ashe seems to be popping off. It's very, very tight. I can't keep track of this, honestly. Orcs on the point. He's burning to death. Red team's coming in hot. I think they do manage to retake this, as Sean is going to struggle against all of this DPS coming in. Mercy does get taken down on the way, though. And Grandma is here. Again, she's still holding that ultimate. Takes the point back 40%. But it's just one take for the blue team. Team Doggos. Much better. To win this one, he's just sneaking around the top here. Barrage is online. Oh, we got the Pharah fight, dude. Big direct coming in from Grandma. Salmon does have the height here. She's panicking a little bit, but she gets it. Dominance has been asserted. She's got the barrage as well. Will she get hooked? If she dodges the hook, she's gonna be good. She's still holding the barrage. Look at this patience. Look at this discipline. Holding it for just the right moment. She knows if she used it, she would have been hooked. Roadhog sneaking around the right side there. Salmon's gone on to the Tracer. It's all going to come down to this hook. Can Grandma survive the hook? She's hiding. She's being patient. Here we go. Here we go. She's got it, dude. The hog is down. Not fast enough on that one. I think that's going to confirm it for the red team here as the blue team jumps onto the point, gets blown up by the Pharah Rocket. And that's going to put us into a 1-1 scenario. Teams very evenly balanced in this little matchup right here. We're going to be bringing this to a third round. In this match. I don't know who's going to win, dude. I'm trying to think who has the advantage here because, I mean, they're so even. Like, I'm going to say, like, well, you know, the red team's got the Symmetra going off. But then in reality, both teams are on Pharahs and both teams are on hit scans. So they're both kind of doing the same thing. The only difference is they got kind of different tank lineups going off, but like... Five, oh, they're on a Nana now. Anna's actually going to help take out that Pharah. Toxic Lima deciding to pick the Anna here. See if anyone gets knocked off the map. The blue team actually decide. Oh, Vintral with the moves here. We got Lucio versus Sombra on the point. Vintral's got to get out of there, though. Oh, he's been taken down, dude. Getting a bit too aggressive there. Fueled by his previous kills. Maybe getting a little bit too cocky. And that looks like it's going to be an easy fight for the red team as they come through here. Orkan trying to escape, and he might just do that. The only way they're going to get this is if they get a fat hook. It doesn't come through. There's Sean charging in. That can't be the right move right there. He's going to get taken down as he is on very low HP. There we go. He does get taken down. They got Pharah coming in, though. Can she do anything? Can she get some knocks off the map here? Maybe. One rocket going straight through the window. They're really nicely placed. The Salmon looks to work on Grandma over here. All right, the red team starting with quite a big advantage. They've got nano boost. The ultimates are way higher. If you just look at the numbers at the top of the screen, they're in the 60s, 70s, 80s. Whereas on the left side of the screen, you got 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s. So the advantage for the red team here is huge. And in King of the Hill, that means everything. Blue team is going around the back here. As we got Sombra going in for a hack. What the hell happened to Iceberg there? I didn't see that. I was not looking, but Iceberg went off the map. But he does get a High Noon double kill, which is going to open up the fight for them right there. Salmon with the kill as well. This is wild, dude. I missed the High Noon. I missed them falling off the map, but somehow they're managing to win this one, which gives Team Doggos a lot of hope. Sean does manage to block the Diva Bomb right there. It's a big delay map. It's really hard to take this point fast, so I'm not going to be surprised if the red team... Oh, the High Noon coming in. The barrage coming in. Grandma taking down three. They're not going to lose the point here. Looking super strong. Even though they're looking like they were going to lose that for a second. The EMP barrage combo was just a little bit too much. Now it's up to Team Doggos to re-push in here. And the only thing they've got is this barrage. And the Hoggle here as well. So it's mostly going to come down to this barrage right here. And they've lost the Mercy as well. So the Pharah is going to be a little bit less strong as they come into this. So I'm looking at the Roadhog here to get something done. Unless Salmon can sneak in. Going for the Pharah kill there. Doesn't manage to get it hacked as well. Gonna be knocked onto the ground and taken down. No barrage coming off. It's all up to the Hoggle now. This is the only thing that possibly got to possibly win this. He vapes, but he gets hacked. It's no good. He's coming into the back line. Can he do anything to the D.Va? No, he's just gonna get shredded. And it looks like the Hamtaros are gonna be taking this one out with a clean, clean round on round number three. GG. The first win in the official Fenner Subscriber League tournament. Play of the game. Goes to the Hamtaros. The first play of the game goes to Nickname. This is the one that really turned it around here as well. Didn't manage to catch it on camera, but has the play of the game. Big shot. Gets the Mercy as well. Nice. TNT was coming out. All right. Not bad, not bad. Just going to go grab some food while the next game gets set up. So the next game, which we need to remember the results, by the way. So this was 2-1 to the Hamtaros. Because this all gets thrown into results. Since this is a three-way, the team with the lowest scores at the end are going to be kicked out for the final match. So the next one is going to be Hamtaros versus the Kitties. And I'm just going to run real fast and grab food while this all gets sorted out. I'll be right back, guys. Gwenpool gifted us up to Hamtaro for the win. Be right back, guys. GG. GG clap. Oh, we got gravy coming off the plate here, chat. Caster needs a little bit of a snack. Oh, it's fucking delicious. We're voting as to a vote. Hang on. So we got Hamtaros versus the Kitties. Let me get the poll ready. New poll. Winner. Hamtaro. Get this. Start poll. Okay. Ready whenever. Match number two in this three-way here. For lunch, we got sprouts, fake chicken, and gravy. Trying to get it all in me before this match starts. Okay, we're gonna have to eat the chicken between rounds. Okay. Welcome to match number two of this three-way. Hamtaro is taking out the first one right there, getting himself a nice lead. We are on Busan here, and on the left side of the map, we got the team you haven't seen yet, which is Team Kitties here. We got Bobby and Notch on the tanks, Hecate and Maltonius on the DPS, and we got Jeff and Amora on the support. And a well-known team here in the Fenner League. We've got New Gamer and Twinkle on the tanks, Nickname and Grandma on the DPS, and Toxic, Lima, and Ren Raven on the support over here as we roll into this. We got a pretty basic composition coming out from the red team. Damage boosted Ash is going to be the way that they're going to be trying to crank out the kills here. And on the other team, we have a surprisingly even team comps again with the blue team. The Kit is going for the Rein'Zaya. Also with the Ash Tracer, but instead of picking the Ana, they've decided to go with the Lucio. So the blue team is going to have the speed advantage, but the red team is going to have more healing to back that up. Probably going to look to Nana boost the Tracer. Big charge coming in from New Gamer on Barbie. They're getting slammed into the wall. And that's going to give them the advantage there. But here's where the speed comes into play. Even though the red team has taken down the enemy Rein, they can't really push into the blue team because they can't keep up with them. They do manage to get pick on the Lucio, though, and that's obviously going to take their speed out of the way. But Jeff getting the res on Amora right there, bringing the speed straight back to the team. And Reinhardt is back in the action as well. We got Nickname against Hecate up at the top here. Mercy a little bit out of position, trying to get drilled by Grandma right there. But going to manage to survive. Toxic Lima in a little bit of trouble, but managing to hold on as she gets healed through everything right there. Let's have a look at Hecate on the other side. He's up top against the enemy. Ash doesn't manage to take him down, missing the last few shots there. A little bit of panic in his aim. Does manage to... The Tracer does get picked on the blue team, though. This is a long fight right here. Hecate coming around the side. Nice little position as Jeff does manage to get the res on Maltonius. This fight is just not ending right here. The sustain from both teams. Kills just not big enough. Bob comes in. Can he be the one to finish it off? He does get booped away. Shields up, but Nickname... Where is he? I don't know where he is. But he's killing everyone. He's popping off. And that's going to allow the red team to just control the point. Blue Bob coming out. I don't know about that one. Hecate's got... I don't know. I feel like he was doing great. And then he panicked a little bit right there. You can see his corpse on the ground. He needs to just slow it down a bit. He's got the adrenaline pumping. He's shaking. He can't handle... Oh, he's making the switch to... No, he's making the switch to Mei. So they're really going to look to abuse the speed here. They're going to look to wall them off and then speed into whoever gets stuck on the wall. And this is going to give them a big advantage as long as they can do it right. Wall's coming in. Oh, he gets taken down on the way in by Nickname, who's completely slaying in this game. On top of the wall here, looking for the frags. Big TNT coming in. I think that TNT might be just a little bit too big as Bobby gets taken down. And I think that's going to be it. As long as he can get this kill on the McCree, yeah, gets taken down. Very, very solid game from the red team. Once they got the point, they just couldn't be taken down with the superior healing, the big plays from Nick. The blue team couldn't find the opening right there. Just couldn't find it.
Ready for battle.
Oh god. Good rounds coming out from Team Kittis right here. Very mannered team. Good sportsmanship coming in. Still on the Lucio. Oh no, switching to the Brig. Interesting composition. So they got an Echo, but they don't have a Mercy to back up the Echo. So they're on Brigitte Moira. And then they got Mei on the enemy team, so they're going to be looking to wall them off. They don't have a speed this time, but both teams no speed, so both teams giving up on the Lucio here in favor of sustain and damage. Red team going to be looking for the wall, but not really finding anything yet. Just over on the other side right there, slow fights from both of these teams. Bobby's actually building up the ult really fast. He already on 80%. Another flame strike coming in 87%. Gonna be the first one to grab an ultimate, I think. So let's get a zoom in here and see what she can do. Does miss that flame strike though, and Grandma takes out Maltonius. Going for a charge, finds something. Is it gonna be enough though? Will she drop the slam? That's the question. I don't think it's a good idea. Oh, she drops it! Let's get a zoom out here, but I don't think they've got enough to take it down. Maybe they do. Let's have a look. Where's Hecate right now? Where is he positioned? He's on the bottom right here. Red team does manage to cap the point, but Hecate's got a really nice position. The only problem is he's on like 1 HP, but he hasn't been seen at the back as he just DPSs away on the healing station. And he hits the visor as well. He's getting away with everything at the back here. And I think that's going to open up the point as another slam comes in already. That's the second slam already from New Game. We're only 15% into the game. He's running away from Nazai here, drops another healing station as he does take out Grandma along the way. He's just completely slaying right here. Let's get a zoom out, better overview of the fight. Graviton Surge coming in on the blue team, and I think that might be a little bit too much. It was a well-fought fight. A very well-fought fight, but like it just wasn't enough as heck he gets taken down. And that was a lot of investment to that. New Gamer coming up on his third Shatter already. We're only at 40%. All he needs is one more hit on this Flame Strike and he's good to go. And I think he's gonna get it right here. Here we go, swinging in. There's no way they expect another Shatter already. He's looking for it. Can he get it? Big wall from Grandma. And the Shatter gets blocked by the Zarya bubble. Pretty sexy right there. Now if we look at the enemy team here, they do have a Graviton Surge coming in. They look like they're gonna go for another pathway. Look at the coordination here. Instant reacting to the call out there. This isn't your typical Overwatch ladder game. This is some high level shit right here, dude. Graviton Surge is coming in. There it is. What do we got here swinging in? Barbie getting a double kill right there. Notch picking up the third as Renraven is at the back. Nickname, can Nickname do this? That's the wrong person. Can Nickname hold the point here even though it's looking like they're on the back foot? Nickname at the back here looking for the frags. Probably wants to go for the Echo first. Maybe jump up top here. Yeah, that's it. Doing every move that they should be doing here. Just gotta click the enemies. Bob's going in. Oh, heck, it's whipped out the Doomfist. They're desperate. They're pulling out the big guns. And here he is, taking down three. They seemed like the well-mannered team. But they're also the first team to pull out the Doomfist. A hero we didn't think we'd see much of in the Fenna Subscriber League. A hero that most people dance game at. But heck it, willing to bring it out for the victory here. Sneaking around the back. What kind of punch can he find? Looking for the Moira. Oh, he doesn't manage to get anything, but jumps in on the Reinhardt there. But it's New Gamer again with another slam. Taking down the point as Barbie tries to hold on with the slam, but gets taken down. And the red team is going to take this out. I think that's going to be all she wrote there. And it looks like the Hamtaros, once again, the kings of the hill. Big Graviton Surge coming in, keeping him off the point. It's very unlikely that the Kitses are going to be able to do anything here. They got to go back to the locker room. Get their head screwed on. They had some good fights, but I just sensed a little bit of panic in their play. Victory. Hamtaro is taking out another one. That means they 100% advance to the finals. Congratulations. To the Hamtaros. A new game of the star of the show, dude. About 5,000 shatters through this game. Second point, there was 3 shatters before 20%. Insane. Alright, so that's going to put us at... Team Doggos are missing a player and our replacements aren't responding. Okay. Who are you missing and what kind of player do you need? Plat tank. Any subs in the chat who are plat tanks? Like, legitimately, don't lie. Because you'll ruin everything if you lie. And bronze on 3-3? I mean, probably. Honestly. We're good? We're good? Did you find someone scroll? I mean, yeah, I feel like Tilly would be in range. If you guys want to take on Tilly. So wait, who did you lose? The Swede. Which Swede? Till you best Alden. Okay, wait, so let me get the score straight. Oh, something happened to Orcs game, okay. So the score right now is... What is it? Doggos 1-2 Hamtaro. Kit is 0-2 Hamtaro. So 4 points for Hamtaro, 1 point for Doggos. So basically... There's 2 scenarios here. 3 scenarios. If Doggos win at all, they're through. If Kittis win 2-0, they're through. But if the game goes 2-1 to Kittis, it's going to be a draw for second place. And we have to do some kind of tiebreaker. If I'm correct. But I'm gonna leave the administration up to the administrators, because I might be wrong on that. But that sounds right. Okay, I think we're ready. So we got Kittis versus Doggos on the PAL. Okay. Shouldn't it be wins first and score for the tie break, which we can't have now? No, because we need a top 2 to send into the finals. It's weird because it's a 3-way, and we're doing it on a score-based system. Traveling to Nepal. Anyway, let's worry about that if it does end up being 1-2 to the Kittis. But yeah, we could do something silly, or we could just do another round. I don't know. We could take, like, the team captains into a 1v1 scenario. Again, it's all for fun. Like, this is not serious stuff. So, like, obviously we want balanced games and stuff. But at the end of the day, it's mostly for fun. All right. Ah, team captain 1v1. Yeah. So if the Kittis go 2-1, then I think we do a 1v1 team captains, because I don't think we talked about that. Unless Simon's already covered it. But I don't remember him covering that scenario, so we'll see. Alright, anyway. So, this is Kittis, right? Yes, Kittis. We got Bobby, Notch, Hecate, Maltonius on the Doomfist. Let's have a look at the other team here. We got Simon on the Echo. Been shown to do really well on Echo so far. Going straight onto that Sombra, but does manage to blink out there. It looks like Indy's gonna get the first frag on Bobby right there, but the res comes in from Jeff. Bobby's straight back on the field, and that could turn everything around right now. But Doomfist does go down, crowd goes wild. And Salmon is hacked over here as well, not looking too hot, but they do manage to cap the point. And it looks like Bobby's gonna get zapped on the way out. Now the blue team has to be looking to get back into this as well. The crowd is voting for the Doggos right here, who do take the lead quickly into this one. They're standing on point with the Reinhardt as well, so breaking through that shield is going to be kind of hard. And we see the first switch coming into the game here. Bobby going onto the Reinhardt, looking to contest this in a straight one-on-one scenario against Sean. Any ultimates coming up? No one's super close right now, but the red team definitely has the advantage. The shield is getting cracked really fast as they come through here, but they're rebuilding it before they go in. Let's see what they can do here. Sean swinging away, looking to go around the right side here. They got Hecate to try and deal with the Echo. It's a slow fight. Shield breaks again. Wall comes up. It wasn't perfect, but they may be able to do it anyway. Shawnee comes rolling in, and looks like Bobby's gonna get taken down as the Nana boost comes in on the Reinhardt here, and Sean's just going huge. I don't know if the nano boost was necessary, so I'm not exactly sure about this one, honestly. But they do manage to confirm the fight there anyway. Now we're going to zoom over to Salmon here as he does have the ultimate ready. He can take over the... Probably going to take over the Reinhardt here and maybe drop on the heads. Yeah, that looks like what he's going to try and do here. So he's going to try and take the Reinhardt, drop on him, build Shatter, and then go huge. Maybe even try to drop behind them here. Oh! They're taking the side path, and here we go. The duplication is coming in! What can he do? Goes for the charge. Bit of a miss. And he gets trapped in a Graviton. Not much coming out of this one. There's a big EMP on the field as well. Graviton Surge going into the blue team. They're all getting stacked up. And the red team going to completely wipe them as Tilly just cleans up with the double kill. And they do manage to take the points. That's going to put the Doggos up 1 point here. The kids are struggling to retake the... And now the Kitsies have to win 2 in a row. Is this for second? Yes. We're fighting for second right now. And if second comes through, then we have a final match between the teams that are in first and second. Again, it's kind of weird because we've got three teams, and it's hard to set up like a three-team tournament. So we're doing it in a strange way, but a way that works. And again, there's not much you can do when it's three teams. It's just weird like that. Okay, what a Team Kit is going to do here. They're going to pull out... I feel like they gotta switch it up. And here they go. They're switching it up. They got... Oh, the Torbjörn, dude. All right, hammer's out. We haven't seen Torbjörn in any of these matches. Definitely a unique pick. Nice little turret placement right there. Does miss the TNT as he moves forward looking for... He's going to look for the Ash kill. Needs to keep him up there. 50%. Nice bubble comes in. They're going to start working on the shield. Tilly takes down Imora off the map with the right click. Looks like Maltonius doesn't really know what to do here. Thinking about going to the back line, but then reeling it in. Maybe thinking it's a bit too much aggressive. But here we go. We got Sean coming in deep. Maybe a little bit too deep. He should get taken down. He gets swung on. But done it. No, does get taken down. That charge was a little bit too aggressive right there as we've got Indy. On the pause. What's happening? What's happening? What's happening, chat? What's happening? Oh! Indy! On the side here. Trying to pop off and hold the point, and it looks like he might be able to do it. S7 gets a few kills along the way as well. Looking super strong right here. I'm really worried for the Kitties right now. What do they need to do to make this happen? Well, honestly, the ult economy doesn't look too bad. Like, even though the red team won that fight, both teams... Looking at pretty similar ult amounts here, so like it's not like there's a massive advantage for the red team in this fight, other than obviously they got the defender's advantage. What the blue team needs to do is take care of the Ash on the right, which they just did. Big grab coming in, but I don't even know if the red team is ready for this. Sean's in deep. I think they can actually kill him here. Slam comes down, but he gets taken down. Jeff with the res. And I think the blue team has a big chance to get in here. The only thing that's going to stop them is this barrage from 7 right here, if he can get it and do it. Oh my god, I thought he was going down the pit. He wants it. Can he get it? The blue team does take the point right there. Barrage is online. Will he go for it? They're doing it without the barrage here. 3 kills onto the red team. Grab comes in. Ventral with the B drop though. Iceberg fighting a turret 1-1 right here. They haven't managed to take the point, but they do manage to take that fight right there. Nobi United. Yo, yo, yo. How's it going? It's going good, man. Thank you for the 3 months, dude. Okay, let's pull out over here. We do have a... We got a huge ult from Bobby possibly coming in. But also, we have a barrage over here ready to go. And we got a Bob ready to go as well. So, like, they got 2 big fat DPS ults. But let's have a look at the front line here. Can Bobby find... the slam that they need to take this point. This is going to be the last fight. Barrage coming in from Seven, getting a double kill, does get hacked out in the sky, and another kill on Iceberg from Maltonius. So we've got a 4v4 situation. Barbie coming in with the charge. And now it's a 3v3. It's so tight. Tilly with the Graviton Surge actually killing Barbie outright there. And Maltonius is on the point. Is he close to ultimate? No, it's not. It's Hecate with the kill, though. Let's have a look at Hecate here. Hecate's got to do it. Oh, Maltonius getting the kill. It's real tight. It's real tight. Can they get it? Hecate does go down. Let's have a look at Maltonius. He's on the point, trying to build his ult. He doesn't have shift ready to go. He does try to TP out there. But Jeff, maybe a big boop could save the day here. Let's have a look. Reinhardt coming in. That's a really good combo right there. Lucio Reinhardt with the speed boost. Oh, he's on the walls. Won't be taken out anytime soon. Barbie just trying to survive, but gets popped by the TNT right there from Indy. And it's not looking... Oh, they broke out the Doomfist again. It's a crazy fight, but it's not looking too good because the Baptiste is low as well. It gets taken down by Salmon. And that's going to be GG right there. Team Kit does get taken out. Dogs proving themselves as superior. Play of the game. Which I personally do not like to her. With the sub as well. In Tilly here on the Zarya. Big grab coming in. Almost 100% charts. Hit the right click. Look at this. Off the bench. Into the game. Fragging out. And that's going to bring us to the final match. It's going to be the Doggos versus the Hamtaros out here. Big shout out to the Kitties for coming out, playing a solid game. Really do appreciate it. No one's gone Widow yet. It's time to place the idea into the players' minds, Ninja. If you just keep typing Widowmaker, maybe some people are going to notice it. And subconsciously, they're going to be like, oh, maybe we go Widow. And Dogs are ready to play Hamsters. Yeah, but so the way this is working, okay? We've done a three-way... And we're taking in account all of the scores. And, well, I can add all the scores together, actually. So we did, I think it was Doggos 1, Hamtaro 2. And then we did Kitties 0, Hamtaro 2. And then we did Kitties 0, Doggos 2, which puts us at 4 for Hamtaro, 3 for Doggos, 0 for Kitties. So that's the three-way score right there. Which puts us into a final between Hamtaro and Doggos. I believe that's correct. Dude, imagine if the Overwatch League just put like a notepad on the screen like this. It'd be great. Anyway, that's the score. So now, grand final. Hamtaro versus Doggos. Look at this, dude. In capital letters. Highlighted. To really hype it up. And it's going to be a best of three. So I think King of the Hill is out of the question now. Oh, I get the honor of picking the map. Wow. You know what, chat? I'm going to pass the honor on to you. To pick the starting map. It's got to be an escort map. I'm going to do a thing here. Junkertown. Rialto. Route 66. Oh, there's one missing. Let me get rid of one. Gibraltar, Rialto. Which one do I hate the most? Gibraltar can go. Okay. You guys get to pick. You guys have the honor of picking the map. No. It has to be an escort map. Them the rules. Rail toe. God damn it, dude. You know, I was gonna pick Rialto, so I like the taste that you guys have got. Is Paris in the map pool? Let's have a look. Did Salmon put Paris in the map pool? Oh no, there's no 2CP. Salmon denied 2CP from this tournament. Which is fair enough, honestly. Okay, map is Rialto. Map is Rialto. Salmon is the tournament admin you didn't know that you needed. Dude, we're gonna do pick the winners here. Winners? Doggos? Hamtaros. Pasta or sandwich? Pasta, unless it's a PB sandwich. That's what I think, mate. That's what I think. Almond butter? No, almond butter is even better. Almond butter is tasty. It's just, I don't really get almond butter because it's like double to triple the price of peanut butter. But almond butter is great. Okay, remember what's on the line here, chat. VIPs for the entire team. 6 VIPs. All right. Trying to rest my voice a little bit, chat. All right, here we go. Jeff starting the match. The gun has been fired. No, VIP is going to last a little bit longer than tomorrow, obviously. I might even do a month. I don't know. It depends how kind of feel. Money's on the Hamtaros, but it's close. 56% versus 44%. It's going to be a walk in the park for the doggos. The fans are already shit talking. Wow. Okay. Let's refresh ourselves on the teams here. So on the blue team, aka the Hamtaros, we've got ourselves. Oh, this is interesting because both teams have a dedicated Pharah player. So on the blue team, on the tanks, we've got New Gamer and we've got Twinkle. On the DPS, we've got Nickname, who's been going off on the Ashe, and we've got Grandma on the Pharah. We got Ren Raven on the Mercy and Twinkle on the D.Va. And then on the enemy team, we got Salmon, another dedicated Pharah player who happens to seem to like Echo as well. Indy on the Ashe. Vintral permanently on the Lucio, I think. Iceberg on the Ana. Sean on the Winston. And Tilly on the Zaya. Did I miss anyone? I don't think so. All right, let's have a zoom in on the Salmon here and see what's happening. Getting hit hard. Straight out the gate right there. Again, they don't have a Mercy here on the Echo. So this is one Echo versus a Pharmacy right here. So it's not going to be an easy fight. This is a very uphill battle for Salmon in the sky. Nickname with the first pick right there. Let's go to have a look at Nickname. That's the Hamtaros. starting off strong. Hamtaro's? Yes. Yes. Starting off strong here. And Grandma with the boop. Tilly going off the map right there. Let's see if they can break the shields. Gonna keep my eye on Nickname here as he has been popping off in the last few matches. Big TNT coming out there, setting the Reinhardt on fire. Having a look over on the left, seeing if they can shut down this Echo. As Seven tries to fight this pharmacy all alone. I don't know if it's the right way to do this. Maybe it's best to just forget about the pharmacy and work on the rest of the team. But he's going for it anyway. He's got blood in his eyes. He wants to assert dominance over Grandma, even though he doesn't have a Mercy. Toxic Lima with the kill on Shawnee there as they push in. Toxic Lima not afraid to output the DPS as Baptiste. And that's a good thing. Always want to be outputting damage when you can. Looking for that Salmon kill as well. Still outputting the damage. Getting a lot of free time to do it. Bob comes in. Will Bob do anything here? He's on the cart. He's kind of got the high ground as the shield gets taken down. And the red team's going to push in here. Can they do it? Bob with one kill on Grandma. Shawnee pushing forward. Looking to get past that Orisa shield as New Gamer has been anted. And here's the push. Indy taking down New Gamer as Tilly is at the front lines. They're zapping down that D.Va. You can't Matrix that beam. And Tilly has herself a Graviton Surge here if she wants to use it. But I think she's going to try and hold on here for a little bit longer. What can the enemy team do to win this? Well, Grandma could go for the barrage on the back line. Gets taken down, though. Not going to happen right there. Let's have a look at Tilly as the blue team tries to contest this with the Bob. I don't know if it's going to be enough. And if they do push, I feel like this Graviton Surge is going to be a little bit too much. Beat is dropped for the red team as they push in here. Looking to drop the grab. And there it goes. The swinging in as well. Twinkle with a kill, but it's not going to... Well, is it going to be enough? Maybe they do get this. I don't know how this is turning around, but the blue team seems to be holding it. Bomb comes out. Salmon on the point. I don't know if he can do it. But they're falling apart. Salmon with a kill. He is a bit mad all over the point, but I feel like the blue team has the advantage here. I've got no idea how they did it, honestly. It was too much to keep track of, but Tilly still on the front line there, fragging out as much as she can. Now starting to struggle a bit and does get taken down. And the blue team looking like they're gonna hold this. It was so goddamn close to getting pushed over the edge right there. But I don't know, maybe it was the Matrix or something, but they just wouldn't die even though they were in the grav. And they just weren't willing to give that up right there. And that puts us in a very awkward situation because they got 50 seconds left on the clock. They're coming in with basically no ultimates here. Ash is getting kind of close to a Bob, but not really. So honestly, it's going to be full reliance on the Ash getting the Bob here or just random picks rather than like a big push with ultimates. TNT coming in, gets the hit, gets the Bob online. Bob goes in. Let's have a look at the Bob here. What's he gonna get up to? He is trying to take down the D.Va right there. The big bad wolf trying to get the kills here for the red team. Looks behind, does take down Grandma. And Bob's doing pretty well considering, but like I still don't think it's gonna be enough as Ventral comes through right there. Oh, he gets the double at the back, but is that enough? Can Tilly do it? I don't think so. Bob's on the point. Let's have a zoom. Oh, Tilly gets taken down right there, and that's going to be it. New Gamer with the hold. The Bob's going huge on both teams. Normally, they just fall asleep, but today, they're fully wired up, dude. It's going to be a difficult push for a difficult hold for Team Doggo over here. That's about where we ended. It did get to about here, though, which I think we'll see soon. Isn't this supposed to move back? Like, right now? Like right now? I guess it teleports in 10 seconds. Please go back. Oh, there we go. Okay, so they got here. Let's take a moment to relax here. Take a nice little boat trip before the action starts.
Attackers incoming.
Yeah, the refreshing sounds of the waves. Thanks, Kane. I'm new here. What are we watching? This is a subscriber tournament here. Subs looking to prove their worth of the VIP status. Anyway, we got distracted. The salmon's breaking out the hammer, man. Honestly, I like this. Attackers incoming. Without a mercy on his back, I don't feel like he can contest the enemy Pharah. And I think the reason why they're not running a mercy is because Vintral, I think Vintral only plays Lucio. And I mean, he's popping on Lucio. And Lucio is not a bad pick. But you gotta bring all of the team synergies together. Salmon gets a pick on the Torbjörn right there. If you've got Lucio, you know, you can't really pick Mercy because you're just not gonna have the heal. So it makes it kind of an awkward situation if you want to play like an Echo or a Pharah. Especially if the enemy team is playing a Pharah with a Mercy. But I'm really liking the Torb pick here, especially against the dive comp coming here from the Hamtaros. It's going to be an extremely hard comp to dive into with Torbjörn and Orisa. A lot of damage output, especially with the shotgun on Torbjörn and the Ash as well. In fact, you can see they're not really diving. They're kind of just standing on the car, and that's not going to be the way to go. Or is it? Because Toxic Lima whips out the big beam and starts to get work done here as Shawnee gets to... Oh, Barrage coming out from Grandma, but gets taken down by Vintral, of course. And there's the res very quickly on Grandma as she comes through, getting the kill on Iceberg. Oh, he's dropping the base. The cheese has not done so well. Couple of patches here and there. Not in the right places at all. Now, we did see the blue team hold this at this point, so maybe it's still possible, but I can tell you right now, dude, this is not looking good because we got the EMP coming up for the blue team as well on 92%. The Bob is almost online for the red team. Oh, pushes the EMP away, trying to get back into the fight for that EMP. Will it happen? There it is, but it's not the best EMP I've ever seen. Grandma with a kill on Salmon, Shawnee with a kill on Toxic Lima, Tilly with a kill on Twinkle. Another res on Grandma. Every time Grandma dies, Grandma is rezzed every single time. This pharmacy combo is doing work for them. She does get taken down by Tilly, but that's a lot of strength. And great hold here by Team Doggos. But yeah, this part is really hard to push because you get here and then you're pushing through another choke point, just like Dorado or something. So it's like a second area that you have to push, and the spawn is pretty close as well. Nickname at the back, taking down Iceberg, working in on Vintral as well. Does manage to get out of there. Vintral getting pretty low on half HP right there as New Gamer comes through. Big Diva Bomb coming in, what's he gonna do? One kill on the Ash, two going down, and the beam coming out from Toxic Lima here as they try to push through. Grandma with the barrage at the back. It's just too many ults for the red team to handle as Vintral gets hacked as well. Salmon getting blown up there on the soldier, and that's gonna be all she wrote, dude. Team Hamtaro gonna take out the first map here. Very good attempt at holding right there, though, even though they did lose on the first point. I think we can see that there's definitely a big chance for this team to take this game out. As Vintral, we watch him take a double environmental kill at the back here. Coming through, let's see what he can do. Flying through. Boom. For a second there, I thought, you know, maybe. Maybe, dude. Alright, so that puts Team Hamtaro up 1 point. This is a best of three. Best of three. Best of three, dude. The next map is going to be hybrid. The losing team chooses the map. So Team Doggos are going to be choosing between Blizzard World, Eichenwald, Hollywood, King's Row, and Numbani. King's Row, you cowards. Yes, I agree. I agree. You don't need to be embarrassed, Tilly. We're all having a good time here. And that's what it's...
Hello.
Hey.
Yo.
Hi-o.
I'm Daniel.
The live What's listening.
It? What are you trying to sneak in all quiet?
He wants what? To hear the comms. It's for the content.
What are the what's the thoughts on the next map?
Let's scream and slam our desk for content.